Every time I hear about GitHub Copilot, I think to myself, it would be nice to have a similar service, but one that I can host locally with no need to send data to Microsoft. And when Copilot inevitably got caught leaking API keys and secrets from GitHub repositories, the self-hosted part pretty much became a requirement to me. Fast forward to 2024, and finally, you can self-host your own code assistant tool on commodity hardware using Docker and Ollama to run our large language models. But why? Well, whether you like it or not, a lot of people who write code for a living use generative AI tools like ChatGPT or GitHub Copilot to some extent. Now, personally, I'm not interested in AI writing all the code for me, so that I can kick back and watch some house instead. What I want from a quote-unquote AI code assistant is more intelligent and more context-aware auto-suggestions. For instance, when I code an Ansible task that has to do with files, I wanted to automatically suggest things like owner, group, and permissions. I would have typed those anyway, but why do that if you can have the machine do it for you? And I'm pretty sure that if you write code for a living, you have your own examples of boilerplate code that you'd rather have your text editor suggest to you automatically. But let's zoom out here for a second. ChatGPT, GitHub Copilot, Anthropic, all those services need entire data centers full of beefy compute nodes to run smoothly. So can we really expect the same level of quality and speed from relatively cheap commodity hardware? Well, that's what I want to find out in this video. And to do that, I've prepared two hardware setups. Our first contestant is Latte Panda Sigma. It's a single board computer based on Intel's Raptor Lake architecture, and it's powered by a 12-core Intel i5-1340P. It's also got 16 gigs of LPDDR5 RAM, which is not upgradable. At idle, the Latte Panda Sigma consumes as little as 5 watts, and even at full load, this little computer only draws as much as 60 watts, but we'll also be measuring exactly how much it draws while running a large language model later on in the video. However, I wouldn't recommend this exact machine, regardless of the results. It's fairly expensive for what it is, and being a single board computer, it doesn't come with a full enclosure. Instead, you should take a look at mini PCs from companies like B-Link, Topton, or Minisforum. A bare bones mini PC with the same kind of CPU would set you back around 300 to 400 euros. So that's what I'll be using for price comparison later on in the video. Our other setup is my gaming PC, based on a Ryzen 7 5800X3D, as well as AMD's top GPU at the time of making this video, AMD Radeon 7900XTX with 24 gigs of VRAM. I built it last summer, and at that time, AMD was the best bang for the buck, at least for my personal needs. As you can see, I've removed the cooling shroud from the GPU and replaced it with two 100mm Noctua fans, as well as some 3D printed ducts and some well-placed rubber dampeners. That way, the GPU runs way quieter and only gets a tiny bit hotter under load. And yes, I have literally no idea what's going on here, so please just ignore it. And yes, the 7900XTX is fully supported by Ollama, so we will be able to run large language models on that GPU. Now, I'm not entirely sure if an NVIDIA card would still provide better results, but the closest NVIDIA card when it comes to VRAM is the 1490, which costs more than this entire build. This PC cost me around 1,500 euros back in summer 2023, which, on the other hand, is quite a bit more expensive than the mini PC, obviously. And I'm really looking forward to seeing how those two builds compare against each other. Now, that being said, a lot of people run Ollama on their laptop, so theoretically, you don't even need a separate device for it. However, this is a channel about home servers and home labs, so chances are, you've been looking for some more stuff to self-host anyway. Running Ollama on a separate device means that you can actually share it with a friend, or use it on multiple devices at the same time. So now that we've talked about the hardware, let's talk software. For the operating system, I'll be using Ubuntu Server 22.04. I'll explain why I went with Ubuntu this time instead of Debian later on in the video. We'll also be running our Ollama instance in Docker, as well as Open WebUI, which is an open source WebUI that would let us chat with our large language models. But the main way we're going to be interacting with our text models is through our text editor. So my main development machine, which is a Mac, I'll be using VS Code as my text editor, as well as a plugin called Continue. Now, personally, 99% of the time, I use NeoVim to write code. However, there actually aren't any great plugins that would provide the kind of functionality I'm talking about. That is, using a local LLM as kind of an auto-completion on steroids, instead of just a glorified chat window inside of your text editor. Now, don't get me wrong, Plugins like model.nvim or gen.nvim also let you define custom prompts, macros, and do other cool stuff. But the only new Vim plugin that I found that uses large language models for auto-completions is LLM.nvim, and unfortunately, I wasn't able to get any kind of good results out of it. The text generation was slow, even with lighter 3B models, and even after tuning parameters like context window, the results it would generate were pretty rough, and seemed to lack new line characters entirely. Now, of course, it could purely be a skill issue on my end, but the solution I eventually went with required like zero fine-tuning. Continue does exactly what it says on the tin, and that is providing GitHub Copilot-style code assistance, but using your local Ollama instance instead of Microsoft servers. Now, they do also allow you to use SaaS providers like ChatGPT, Mistral, and Anthropic, but we're obviously not gonna do that in this video. According to the developers, a new Vim extension is in the works, and that would actually be really nice for those of us who don't use VS Code or IntelliJ. Now that I've bored you to death with the software part as well, let's finally install our operating system and configure Ollama. I started up with setting up my beefy desktop machine first to kind of get a baseline of ideal performance under the circumstances. Now, usually, at least since a couple of years, I tend to go with Debian for my self-hosted project videos. However, it seems that ROCm, which we need to run large language models on our 7900 XTX, is not supported on Debian. I've tried to get it to work, but in general, the consensus in the community, by which I mean Reddit, seems to be just to stick to Ubuntu. So that's what I did, and after installing Ubuntu Server 2204, I also installed the dev package for the driver installer from AMD's website, and then ran the AMD GPU install script with use case equals ROCm. Then I installed Docker Engine using the official tutorial from the Docker's website. I won't be going through this in detail since it's literally just copy-pasting a few commands, and I'll leave a link to it down in the video description. To run the Ollama instance, we'll be using Docker Compose, and this is what my Docker Compose file looks like. Apart from Ollama, we're also running Open WebUI, which is basically a ChatGPT-like WebUI for Ollama that runs locally and lets you interact with large language models and also download new ones right in your browser. Here, we're setting up the Open WebUI, forwarding the port 8080 and pointing the WebUI container to the Ollama endpoints. Finally, we're mounting a local folder inside the container to make sure that our settings persist. Next, we're using the ROCm version of the official Ollama container to make sure that it utilizes our AMD graphics card. Then, we're forwarding the port 11434 to use the Ollama endpoint with our text editor. We're also mounting a local directory inside the container to make sure that our models persist through the Docker Compose down command. And finally, we're using the device parameter to mount devkfd and devdri inside the container. These are the Unix devices that belong to our GPU, and that's what's going to let us utilize our graphics card. And that's it. It's a really simple compose file, and I'm going to put a link to it down in the video description. And if you develop your own Docker containers, you should take a look at Docker Scout. It lets you scan your Docker containers for security vulnerabilities, CVEs, license violations, outdated base images, and gives you a nice overview of all the problems and potential fixes. It integrates with all the popular CI/CD tools and pulls data from multiple security trackers so that you never miss a high-impact vulnerability. Docker Scout also lets you set policies for your images and makes sure that the images that get uploaded to your company's repo fulfill them. For instance, you can require that all images use a non-root user, or you can set a list of approved base images that the developers are allowed to use. Scout already comes with some common sense policies out of the box, and you can customize and tighten them to your company's needs. Docker Scout is free for up to 3 repositories and also comes with unlimited local image analysis, both for personal accounts and organizations. You can check out the pricing for team and business plans down in the video description. And now, let's get back to self-hosted AI. Before being able to run my Docker Compose project, I also had to reboot so that Ollama will recognize my GPU. But after rebooting the machine, navigating to the Compose folder, and running Docker Compose up, it kinda just worked. So I opened the browser on my MacBook, went to the server's IP address plus the port 8080, and registered the admin account. And there you go, we're in. So in order to test out the performance of our setups, I downloaded a few models that are usually recommended in the community for code assistance. Code Llama in the version 7b, Ooga Booga Code Booga, Yes, really. And Star Coder in the 3B version. I then asked Ollama to generate some Ansible code for setting up Ollama on Linux, using the code Booga model. Loading the model into VRAM for the first time takes a little bit of time, but once the model is loaded, the text generation is pretty snappy. And with a few extra prompts, it even produced something that didn't look like a complete hallucination, which is nice. Looking at Radeon top, you can see that the model takes up almost all the VRAM on the card, so it's definitely going to be an interesting experience running models of that size in the Latte Panda Sigma.
Foreshadowing is a literary technique in
And now that we've seen that our models work in a WebUI, let's see them in action. So I opened VS Code and installed the Continue plugin from the marketplace. I then opened the JSON configuration and set the URL of my Ollama instance, as well as the model for the chat and auto suggestions. I found it cool that you can specify multiple models for chat, and also set your code completion model separately. You're probably going to want to have a lighter 7B or even 3B model for auto suggestions, and leave beefy 34B and 70B models for chat interactions. And after going back to the code editor and creating a playbook YAML file, well, you can see the result for yourself. The code Booga suggestions were pretty good. As you can see, it correctly recognized that I'm writing a playbook file and not a role, and started the suggestion with hosts all. Code Llama 7B, on the other hand, thought I was writing a task file for a role, but apart from that, the suggestions that it generated were pretty good as well. At the same time, the code Booga model, being a 34B one, was a tiny bit slower when it comes to auto-completion. In general, both models performed well enough, at least during my, granted, very limited testing. I've also tested both models out quickly with Python, and so far, all the suggestions that I've seen actually make sense. Now, do keep in mind that some models perform better in some languages and worse in others, so I'd suggest trying it out for yourself and seeing what works for you. Apart from code suggestions, Continue also has a chat functionality, which lets you chat with the model without leaving your text editor. So now we get to the most interesting part of the experiments, at least for me, and that is power consumption. Now, the build that I'm using to run Ollama has not been built with power efficiency in mind. It's got a chiplet design AM4 Ryzen CPU, which are not known for their great idle power efficiency. And it's also got a high-end AMD graphics card, which are likewise known to have issues with power consumption. At idle, our AI server consumes around 63 watts, and while generating auto-suggestions for our code, that number goes up from anywhere between 110 watts all the way up to 425 watts, and the average works out to around 130 watts, which is actually way less than I expected. Interestingly enough, I didn't see much of a difference between using a lighter model like Code Llama 7B and using something like Code Booga 34B. In both cases, the power consumption average stayed at that 130 watt mark. So considering that power draw figure, and considering the upfront cost of a decent GPU with loads of VRAM, the obvious question is, can we run this on something less power hungry and less costly and still get decent results? In order to see that, I've installed Ollama on the Latte Panda Sigma, which I've already made a video about in the past. With 16 gigs of RAM and a laptop tier Intel processor, it's not really made to be an AI powerhouse, but that's the kind of specs that you're more likely to see in a machine that you might have lying around. More likely than a 1.5 grand gaming PC anyway. So I've configured the Ollama instance with the same Docker Compose file that I use for my gaming machine, with two exceptions. I've used the latest tech for Ollama instead of ROCm, and I also removed the mounts for the AMD graphics card, obviously. Then I started the Docker Compose stack, and as you can see, even though Ollama did not detect a compatible GPU, it still started no problem. So I went to the Open WebUI instance in the browser, downloaded the models, and after a few minutes, we're now ready to start. I decided to start with the code Booga model to really stress test the little machine. Little did I know, running a model that big is out of the question. Code Booga model needs 20 gigs of RAM, whereas we only have 16. So Code Llama it is. And even though that model worked just fine, the text generation was very slow. For comparison, here's my gaming machine generating a response to the same prompts. Out of curiosity, I decided to try the Star Coder 3B model, to see if using a smaller model would speed up the process. And even though the text generation was a tiny bit faster this time around, the result was two pages of the worst AI hallucinations I've ever seen. Eventually, the model seemed to give up completely, outputting whatever this is. Now, once again, Ansible is not the most popular use case for these kind of models, and I imagine that both models would fare better with something like Python or Java, but nevertheless, we're definitely not off to a great start. So let's test this setup with code completions. So I went over to VS Code and changed the Ollama endpoint in the continue settings to the latte panda sigma. I chose code llama 7b for my completion model, went to the main YAML file, and started typing. And guys, I really wanted this setup to be viable when it comes to AI-generated code assistance, but the suggestions were so slow and unreliable that I personally found it easier to just write the tasks myself. Unfortunately, changing to a lighter model, in this case StarCoder 3b, didn't really help. The few initial suggestions that it gave were fine, if a bit slow, but after the first task, it kind of just seemed to give up entirely. So I guess that a GPU really does give you a major boost when it comes to working with large language models, and without a dedicated graphics card, with support for CUDA or ROCm, you're probably going to be stuck with a setup that's slow enough to be unusable in some cases, like for instance code suggestions. Which is a shame, because in terms of power draw, this little PC crushes my gaming setup. The Latte Panda Sigma draws as little as 4.6 watts at idle, and around 40 to 60 watts when working with large language models. So now we come to the biggest question of this video. Who is this even for? Now, don't get me wrong. The fact that you can run a large language model that is comparable in quality to something like ChatGPT, even on the most surface level, at your own house, using free and open source software and consumer hardware, that's amazing. But at the same time, it basically needs a high-end graphics card to work well. And building a 1,000+ euro computer just to get some better code suggestions in your IDE is probably not the smartest idea ever. On the other hand, if you already have a decent gaming or workstation PC, this could probably save you a subscription to some SaaS products. Now personally, I found the code suggestions produced by models like Code Buga and Code Llama pretty useful, but maybe not useful enough to run 130 watts of compute every time I want to write code. But what do you guys think? Would you run the setup yourself, or are you a NeoVim Chad? Anyway, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and as usual, I would like to thank my patrons: Scott Huffman, Matthew K, Alessandro Colori, Jubastica, Christoph Mueller, James Eppington, David Love, Robust Dream of Crypto, and everyone else supports this channel. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.